marriage are very well known to all of us, particularly from a hadith which has been reported by Imam At-Tirmizi, may Allah have mercy on him, and it has been authenticated by His Eminence Sheikh Muhammad Nasir in his book Irwa'ul Ghalil, in which our beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam says, La nikaha illa bi waliyin wa sadaqin. There is no marriage without wali, meaning the guardian of the bride and the wakil, the representative of the bridegroom. And secondly, there must be bride price, that is al-mahar. And thirdly, there must be witnesses. A minimum of two people should witness, or otherwise, in some countries like Saudi Arabia, that condition of witnesses, they do not emphasize it much. They are more interested in announcing the marriage contract, or maybe to publish it on newspapers or in television or in the radio stations, what they call an ilan, like announcement. So these are the conditions. There must be bride price, there must be the guardian, that is waliyul mar'a, and there must be a representative of the bride groom, that is al-wakil, and there must be at least two witnesses. These are the conditions. However, on the issue of writing any agreement, in Islam, whatever Sharia remains silent on it, meaning is legitimate. However, we should not make it something that is obligatory. For example, you intend to get married to someone, and you realize that he has some weaknesses that you could not be able to stay with him comfortably until he addresses them. Sometimes it could not be weaknesses. Maybe you want to have an agreement with him that after marriage, you will go to school. You want to go and study medicine. And you feel like if this is not well documented, he may challenge you after the marriage. In Islam, it's allowed for you to mention some conditions that you feel are necessary for you, while they are not obligatory Islamically, but to you they are very necessary, like you want to further your education, or you, as a man, you want to get married to a sister, and you feel like if you get married to her, you don't want her to go and walk outside your own house. Because of this, you intend to give her a monthly allowance of 50,000 naira. That is an example. With the condition that she will not get any employment and leave your house. If she agrees with this, there is no harm in documenting this agreement. Because of a hadith which has been reported by Imam Bukhari, may Allah have mercy on him, in which our beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Al-Muslimuna ala shurutihim. Muslims are on their conditions. Whatever you and your husband agree on, and it is not in any way trying to legitimize haram or trying to prohibit halal, then it's allowed Islamically. So these are some of the issues that if they are documented, they are allowed Islamically. This is the opinion of Sheikh Muhammad Saleh Al-Fusaymin, rahimahullah ta'ala, in his book Sharh Al-Mumti ala Zad Al-Mustaqni. Documenting these conditions, there is nothing harm in doing that. This is well known in countries like Saudi Arabia. I just discussed with my brother, Dr. Muhammad Salah. He said they usually document all these agreements in their marriage contract in Egypt. So there is no harm in doing that. And Allah knows best.
Jazakumullah khairan.